Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome to another session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and ABAT. And remember guys, this is for the ESI current affairs, not for the static part. Alright, for the static part you have to cover some more things also. Okay, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you can receive all the latest notifications regarding the videos. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions and also about the courses. So let's talk about the very first question, which is about a standard developing organization. So the question is, which institute has been declared as the very first standard developing organization under One Nation, One Standard mission of BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards? So this One Nation, One Standard mission was announced in the year 2019, and the idea behind this mission guys is that there should be a one particular standard of development for a particular product. Okay, ek product ke liye ek particular standard hona chahiye uski development ka. So basically ek nation ek standard, iske naam se hame pata chalta hai, is for designing a product with one particular standard only. Okay, there should not be multiple standards for designing a product, all right? And that product can be anything. Now the news is that the Research, Design and Standards Organization of Indian Railways has become the first institution that is to be declared as the standard developing organization under this mission, which is known as One Nation, One Standard mission. And remember, this mission is implemented by Bureau of Indian Standards. Now after this, all the private and public equipment manufacturers, services and process developers of the railway sector would now get the benefit of one specialized standard by this organization, which is known as Research, Design and Standards Organization. So basically ab se kya hoga, jitne bhi public or private equipment manufacturers hai ya koi bhi services hai Indian Railways ki ya railway sector ki hum overall baat kare, to us sab ke liye ek particular standardization hoga har product ke liye. Okay, and talking about One Nation, One Standard, so as I told you that it was, the idea was conceived in the year 2019 in order to ensure quality products in the country. And the basic idea guys is to develop one template of standard for one given product instead of having multiple agencies set it. Okay, so as I told you, ek particular product ke liye ek particular standard hoga, that will bring, you know, ek usme uniformity aayegi. Okay, and it is also to attain the One Nation, One Standard vision of the Government of India, and this was launched and this provides for recognition of SDO, and this recognition guys is valid for 3 years and it requires renewal after 3 years of after completion of 3 years. Okay, so this was about this news, and therefore the correct answer is what, option B, Research, Design and Standards Organization of Indian Railways. And remember, this RDSO is located at Lucknow. It is located at Lucknow and it is the only research and development wing of Indian Railways, and it does the work of standardization for Indian Railways. Okay, so here option B is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2, which is about a startup. So Mumbai based startup Indra Water has developed Vajra Kavach. So you have, the question is, what is it? So what is this Vajra Kavach? Ye hai kya aakhir? Now let's talk about this. So Mumbai based startup Indra Water has developed Vajra Kavach, which is nothing but a disinfection system. Now this disinfection system will work for what? It will remove all the traces of viruses from the used PPE kits, from the coats, from the gloves, from the N95 masks and from the gowns. Basically from all the protective equipments, this disinfection system will remove all the traces of virus. Now with the implementation of this, with the help of this, now the protective equipments can be made reusable, and it will also help in reducing the biodegradable waste materials. Alright, and this disinfection guys, remember, can be done in just a few minutes, and every component used in this in the manufacturing of this disinfection system is made in India, giving a boost to the Make in India project of the Government of India. Okay, so basically Vajra Kavach ek disinfection system hai jo ki कोरोना वायरस के ट्रेसेस को रिमूव करेगा फ्रॉम द प्रोटेक्टिव इक्विपमेंट्स लाइक पीपीई किट्स, लाइक मास्क, लाइक गाउन्स, लाइक ग्लव्स. ऑलराइट, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी व्हाट, ऑप्शन ए, डिसइंफेक्शन सिस्टम फॉर इक्विपमेंट्स यूज्ड बाय कोरोना वॉरियर्स. एंड रिमेंबर इट्स सिग्निफिकेंस, देयर आर टू इंपॉर्टेंट सिग्निफिकेंस. वन इज दैट इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस द पर्सनल प्रोटेक्टिव इक्विपमेंट्स एंड अदर प्रोटेक्टिव इक्विपमेंट्स कैन बी मेड रीयूजेबल, एंड ऑल्सो इट विल हेल्प इन improving the environment by reducing the biodegradable waste. All right. So now let's come to question number 3, which is about ECLGS 4.0. So again, once again, ECLGS has been extended by the government of India. The question is, what is not correct regarding this expansion? इसमें से क्या not correct है या incorrect है regarding this expansion? So let's talk about this expansion, guys. So the news is that the government has expanded the emergency credit line guarantee scheme, and the name given is ECLGS 4.0. And this is obviously on account of the disruptions that has been caused by the second wave of coronavirus in our country to almost all the businesses. Okay, हमारे जितने भी businesses हैं उसको सबको इफेक्ट किया है इस coronavirus ने, तो उनको जो भी disruptions आई हैं उसमें उनको help करने के लिए this ECLGS has been extended. Now talking about the background, so ECLGS हमें याद, अगर आपको पता हो, if you remember that ECLGS was launched in the last year during the COVID-19. When the COVID-19 started, ECLGS, the government had launched ECLGS to support the business sector of our country. So to mitigate the continuing adverse impact of pandemic, the government has been extending the scope of ECLGS. इससे पहले ECLGS 2.0 आया, 3.0 आया, now it is ECLGS 4.0. Right, in November 2020, if you remember, the government had extended the scheme through ECLGS 2.0 for 26 stressed sector which were identified by the KV Kamath committee. Also in the March 2021, ECLGS 3.0 was introduced to cover 4 sectors, which are hospitality, travel and tourism, leisure and sporting sector. 4 naye sectors ko third version mein add kar diya gaya tha. Now talking about the fourth version mein kya hua hai, the 100% guarantee cover will be provided to the loans of up to rupees 2 crores to all the hospitals, nursing homes and all the medical establishments for setting up of on-site oxygen generation plants. So, हमने देखा था कि oxygen में कितनी ज़्यादा कमी आ गई थी, कितनी ज़्यादा requirement कितनी ज़्यादा बढ़ गई थी because of second wave of COVID. So, अब on-site oxygen generation plant के लिए government is providing 100% guarantee to the loans for setting up of these oxygen generation plants up to rupees 2 crores. And also the scheme has been extended till September 30, 2021 or till rupees 3 lakh crore is sanctioned. 3 lakh crore jab tak sanction nahi ho jate ya fir 30 September 2021 dono mein se jo pehle ho jayega, the scheme is implemented till that point. All right, but remember the disbursements are allowed till 31st December 2021. A person can avail the facility till 30th September 2021 or till this much amount, rupees 3 lakh crore is sanctioned. But the disbursements are allowed till 31st December 2021, which is the last year, which is the last day of this year. Okay. Now remember, guys, the scope of ECLGS 1.0 has also been expanded. The scheme validity, the scheme is now valid till 30th September 2021, and there is an additional credit assistance of up to 10% of outstanding as on 29th February 2020, jo already diye chuke hain. उसके अलावा 10%, which means this is the additional credit assistance in addition to the already given assistance. Okay. Now the loan का जो tenure है will be how much? 5 years, comprising repayment of interest only during first 2 years and interest and principal in 3 years thereafter. Okay. So basically the tenure of the loan has been extended from the earlier 4 year to now 5 years. Okay. And talking about the expansion of ECLGS 3.0 also, so earlier there were hospitality, travel and tourism, leisure and sporting sector, and now the civil aviation sector is also eligible. It is also valid till 30th September 2021, and earlier there was a ceiling on the outstanding amount. One second. Yes, so earlier there was a ceiling on the outstanding amount which was rupees 500 crore, but now this ceiling has been removed and the assistance to each borrower will be provided as 40% of total credit outstanding or rupees 20 crore whichever is lower. Ab isme outstanding jo bhi loan hai uske liye koi ceiling nahi hai, koi limit nahi hai, bas ye hai 40% of the total credit outstanding jo bhi hoga or rupees 200 crores whichever is lower, iske hisab se jo amount hai, jo loan hai, wo sanction kiya jayega to the business houses. Okay. So I hope, guys, this news is clear, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the incorrect statement here. Guarantee cover is given for setting up on-site oxygen generation plant. This is absolutely correct. Loan up to 2 crores एंड रिमेंबर द इंटरेस्ट फॉर दिस विल इज कैप्ड एट 7.5%, 7.5% का इंटरेस्ट रेट देना होगा मेडिकल एस्टैब्लिशमेंट्स को. सिविल एविएशन सेक्टर इज ऑल्सो मेड एलिजिबल टू अवेल बेनिफिट ऑफ द स्कीम. येस, अंडर द एक्सपेंशन ऑफ ECLGS 3.0 टू ECLGS 4.0, नाउ द सिविल एविएशन सेक्टर इज ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड. रीपेमेंट टेन्योर अंडर ECLGS 1.0 इज एक्सपेंडेड टू 5 years. सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स गाइज आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, विच मीन्स ऑप्शन डी ऑल आर करेक्ट, शुड बी द करेक्ट आंसर. None of the statement is incorrect. Okay. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is about the Model Tenancy Act. So recently the government has passed this act. So you have to consider the following statements with regard to this act and identify which is are not correct. So let's talk about this. So the Union Cabinet has approved the Model Tenancy Act to enact legislation or amend laws on rental properties. And remember, this Tenancy Act is not binding on the state governments or the UT governments. They are free to make their own legislation, but this act will act as a model Tenancy Act for those states and UTs. Okay. And remember, it was drafted by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs in the year 2019. And remember, it is aimed at creating a vibrant, sustainable and inclusive rental housing market in the country. And it will also balance the interests and rights of both the landowner, house owner and the tenant. Now let's talk about some basic provisions of this act. So there will be a written, mandatory written agreement between the property owner and the tenant. Iske alawa, there will be an independent authority and a rental and a rent court. So it will, in every state and UT, there will be an independent authority to deal with the matters of the tenancy, and also there will be a separate court to take up tenancy related disputes. Now the maximum limit for security deposit has been assigned. For residential purposes, it is a maximum of 2 months rent, and for commercial purposes, it can be to a maximum of 6 months rent. Okay, जो residential purposes है उनके लिए कितना हो सकता है maximum 2 महीने का rent, और commercial purpose के लिए अगर कोई tenant आ रहा है तो उसके लिए कितना होगा 6 महीने का rent. Alright. Now these are some rights and obligations of both landlord and tenant. Like for landlord, landlords will be responsible to repair the structural damages. The structural damages का जो repair कराने की जिम्मेदारी है वो landlords की है, and also to undertake measures like whitewashing walls and painting doors and windows. And talking about the responsibilities and the obligations of tenant, so they will be responsible for drain cleaning, switches and socket repairs, kitchen fixtures repairs, replacement of glass panels and window. Basically जो छोटे मोटे repairings होते हैं, the small small repairs will be done by the tenant, while if there is any structural damage, that repair will be done by landlord. All right. A landowner will have to give 24-hour prior notice before entering the rented premises to carry out the repairs or the replacement. If any landlord wants to repair or replace any structural damage that is there in his property, in his or her property, then he or she has to give a 24-hour prior notice to the tenant. Also, there is a mechanism for vacating the premises under this Model Tenancy Act. This is, guys, very important. You should remember this. If a landlord has fulfilled all the conditions stated in the rented agreement, like he or she has given the notice to the tenant, and the tenant, if the tenant fails to vacate the premises on the expiration of the period of tenancy, then the landlord is entitled to double the monthly rent for 2 months and 4 times after that. शुरू के 2 महीने में वो रेंट को डबल कर सकता है अगर जो टीनेंट है उसने खाली नहीं किया आफ्टर द एक्सपायरेशन ऑफ द पीरियड ऑफ टीनेंसी. शुरू के 2 महीने में डबल हो सकता है और उसके बाद 4 times भी कर सकता है. एंड ऑल्सो द लैंडलॉर्ड वुड गिव अ नोटिस इन राइटिंग 3 months बिफोर रिवाइजिंग द रेंट. 3 महीने पहले उसको रिटर्न में नोटिस देना होगा इफ ही और शी वॉन्ट्स टू रिवाइज द रेंट. एंड ऑल्सो द लैंडलॉर्ड कैन नॉट हाइक द रैंक इन द मिडल ऑफ द टेन्योर. बीच में वो जाके कभी भी हाइक नहीं कर सकता. सो इट इज़ वेरी गुड एक्ट. बेसिकली ये जो टीनेंट और लैंडलॉर्ड्स के बीच में जनरली कन्फ्लिक्ट रहता था, ये उसको काफी ज्यादा हेल्प करेगा रिमूव करने में. ऑलराइट, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. द ड्राफ्ट एक्ट हैड बीन पब्लिश्ड बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स इन 2019. यस, करेक्ट. इट इज मैंडेटेड फॉर द स्टेट्स टू एनैक्ट इट विदाउट एनी चेंज. नो, दे कैन अमेंड द प्रोविजंस ऑफ दिस एक्ट, एंड इट विल एक्ट एज अ Model Act for all the states and UTs, and they are free to legislate their own legislation. Okay, and according to the Act, maximum limit for security deposit for commercial purpose premises 6 months. This is absolutely correct. So only second statement is incorrect, which means option C will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. So the Union government has approved the signing and ratification of an agreement on cooperation in the field of mass media between all the member states of Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO. Question is, which of the following is not correct about the cooperation area under this agreement? So let's talk about this. So the question itself says that the Union government has approved the signing and ratification of the agreement on cooperation in the field of mass media. So there will be a cooperation in the field of mass media among the member states of SCO, and it will definitely provide an opportunity to the member states to share new innovations and best practices in the field of mass media. Now these are some provisions, these are some features of this cooperation, like there will be creation of favorable conditions for wide and mutual distribution of information through the mass media. Basically, information ka distribution hoga through the mass media. There will be cooperation among all the stakeholders in the field of mass media. Promotion of equal and mutually beneficial cooperation between professional associations of journalists. Assisting broadcasting of television and radio programs which are distributed legally, or you can say officially, within the territory of the state or the other side. The exchange of experience and specialists in the field of mass media. Providing mutual assistance in training media professionals, and also to in educational and scientific research institution, there will be cooperation after the ratification and signing of this agreement. Now the thing is, aapko itni sari cheeze yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Agar exam bahut zyada difficult hua tabhi isme se question aa sakta hai. Just isme se jo important, basically ye important hi hai, aapko agar yaad ho jate hain to well and good, agar nahi ho pa rahe hain कोशिश करना दो चार बार पांच बार याद करने की, अगर नहीं हो पाएंगे तो छोड़ना, ठीक है. एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आइडेंटिफाई करना है. असिस्टिंग ऑफिशियल एंड अनऑफिशियल डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड ब्रॉडकास्ट ऑफ टेलीविजन एंड रेडियो प्रोग्राम्स. नो, नॉट अनऑफिशियल, विच मीन्स दिस स्टेटमेंट इज इनकरेक्ट ओनली, बट लेट्स रीड आउट द अदर ऑप्शंस आल्सो. प्रमोटिंग कोऑपरेशन बिटवीन प्रोफेशनल एसोसिएशन ऑफ जर्नलिस्ट, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. Encouraging the exchange of experience and specialists in the field of mass media, this is also correct. Encouraging cooperation among educational and scientific research institutions and organizations operating in this field, this is also correct. And providing mutual assistance in training media professionals. So all the statements, all the statements, B, C, D, E are absolutely correct, which means the correct answer should be what? Option A, because we have to identify the statement which is incorrect. Alright. So guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And if you have liked this session, then do share it with your friends and family. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.